It is also $3,000 more expensive at a recommended retail price of $14,000 USD. This is a capable scanner. Guys, you don't really need to worry about the scanner dropping out as long as the scanner cradle itself is actually plugged in. Hey guys, Dr. Ahmad Al-Hassiny here from the Institute of Digital Dentistry. And today I wanted to go over a full review of the Aoralscan 3 wireless intraoral scanner, which we have been testing here at IDD for over a year now. Shining 3D, the company behind the scanner, has been busy updating their software to make the scanner competitive in this market. They have released some interesting new features, which I wanted to share with you in this review. So let's get into it. Right, so this is Shining 3D Aoralscan 3 Wireless. And it's essentially the same as the previous generation Aoralscan 3, but obviously now wireless. Now this Aoralscan 3 is a scanner I have already reviewed, and you can check that out on the IDD website. But for those of you who may not know about it, it's basically a really good economic option from China. And it is probably one of the best intraoral scanners from that region. Although all scanners can now scan a crown fast, the key differentiating factor is software. And Shining 3D has really invested a lot into their software. The company also is quite interesting, as they actually make and sell a bunch of digital dentistry solutions, like a pretty decent 3D printer, which they recently updated, the AccuFab Cell, and quite a good facial scanner, the MetiSmile, which I've already done a full video review on, so you can check that out. But today is not about their other products. It's about the scanner. And long story short, guys, it scans well, which is really an expectation in the scanner market in 2024. I've been using the previous generation Aoralscan 3 and now the wireless for basically every dental indication, whether it's crowns, bridges, implants, smile makeovers, partially edentulous scans, fully edentulous scans, etc. It does a good job for basically every dental indication. This is a capable scanner. With edentulous scanning, the company has really worked on their software workflow, improving edentulous scanning, but also including copy denture software workflows and scanning wax rims. Overall, it's decent for edentulous scanning, but this is an area that still needs improvement. So what has changed in the wireless version? Well, most of it is the same, except the wireless part. So the company has done quite a good job with the design, to be honest. The batteries that sit in here last 2 hours of continuous scanning and can be easily removed and put back in. In sleep mode, the company says they can last up to 10 days, which is impressive. I never got to test that, I didn't have the patience. But if the batteries die, you can simply charge them using this battery charger, which can hold 3 batteries. And what is cool is that the scanner cradle itself is also a battery charger. So as long as the scanner is held here, which it is if you don't use it, it is always charging the battery. Basically, it means the batteries are always ready to use. It has taken the best of both worlds. Battery chargers like Medit and Trios 5 use, and charging cradles like Dexis and Allied Star uses. The wireless connection itself works well, and it uses Wi-Fi 6 technology to keep a stable connection. These days, most if not all wireless scanners are capable of holding a consistent connection. So guys, you don't really need to worry about the scanner dropping out as long as the scanner cradle itself is actually plugged in. Because the cradle itself acts like the Wi-Fi dongle, which I personally prefer over those TP-Link dongles that are common with other wireless scanners. I don't know, I just feel like this feels a little bit more premium, a little bit more well thought out. The only downside that you have to keep in mind is that if you want to use the scanner, the cradle has to be connected, not only to the power socket, but also to your laptop, because again, this is the Wi-Fi dongle. And in saying that, this can be annoying, especially if you want to move the scanner quickly between different clinics. So wireless tech aside, the company also improved the heating of the scanner tips, which I noticed straight away, because these new scanner tips heat up in around 40 seconds, which is pretty good in this market, and much better than the previous generation Aoralscan 3 wired scanning tips, which used to take a couple of minutes. Now, speaking about the scanner tips, I wanted to take a second to talk about the Aoralscan 3 scanning tips, because I'm not sure what it is. I think it's the kind of narrow, long, beak-like scanner tip, but I really find these to be some of the best scanning tips to scan tight to reach areas like distal of terminal molars. It really is a good and well-designed scanning tip for these areas, and overall I've just found they work really well. That aside, this scanner is everything that you liked about the Aoralscan 3, but wireless. And this seems to be a trend the entire industry is going towards. I mean, except Medit with the i900. And speaking of wireless, of course, there are many benefits, mainly related around ergonomics, and generally they are more enjoyable to use. So all the positives are there. What are the downsides? I mean, for one, because of all this wireless technology that's built in the back, this scanner weighs 100 grams more than the previous generation wired scanner. It is also $3,000 more expensive at a recommended retail price of $14,000 USD. Now, this does make it one of the lowest cost wireless intraoral scanners on the market, but you are paying $3,000 more for this luxury compared to the wired version. Right, so hardware aside, what else has been happening with Shining 3D? Well, they've been busy working quite extensively on their software. For one, they now enable you to add extra scan data to any patient case. This is very similar to what Medit popularized, and it is an awesome feature to see in this scanner. Basically, it gives you full flexibility in any case to add any extra scan data, such as if you're scanning pre-ops, perhaps multiple different wax-ups, or an impression, etc. So, speaking of scanning impressions, the scanner software also now detects automatically if you're scanning within the mouth or out of the mouth, such as a physical impression or model, and will remind you to switch the scanning settings between extraoral and intraoral scanning. And these settings basically just prime the AI to make scanning easier for you. Adding to this, the software also now enables you to add multiple jaw relation bite scans to a case, not just left and right. For example, for sleep appliances, you may want to give your lab a CR bite and then also give them an open bite via a leaf gauge. So these are not groundbreaking, but there are a couple of quality of life features, which is nice to see the company adding to their scanner software and keeping it in line with the competition. This company is obviously serious about being a competitive player in this intraoral scanner market, because many of the other low-cost scanners don't offer all of this. The other interesting thing to see Shining 3D develop is their scanning apps. Everyone knows that scanners are all fast, and basically all can handle basic scan indications quite easily. But what is separating scanners now is software apps, integrations, and AI. These again were popularized by Medit, and we see them in Trios, and now Aoralscan 3 also has a range of different apps. The company has been busy developing their software, including a number of different features. For one, they have an orthodontic simulator. This is called ConsulOS. And look, it doesn't really need a lot of explanation because I'm sure many people know orthodontic simulators can be hugely powerful communication tools, and they help with case acceptance. Like all other ortho simulators, how it works is you scan a patient and then the potential effects of ortho treatment can be simulated. It works well enough, not the best, and that crown goes to iTero that has the best ortho simulator, but it's nice to have an economic scanner option. What is interesting and sets Shining 3D apart is that if you also have their face scanner, the MediSmile, you can align the facial and intraoral scan data and carry out that simulation. And the facial morphology changes along with the teeth change. It's pretty cool. Second is what the company calls ConsulReport. This is quite a cool feature, and we're seeing more and more of this in the intraoral scanner market these days. Basically, it's a way for an oral health report to be automatically generated after scanning by AI. So the AI can pick up and denote a range of different features, caries, recession, etc. And this helps frame the intraoral scanner as not just a digital impression device, but a tool to use in every patient examination. And these reports can be printed or sent to the patient very easily through the software. Adding to this, they have another software called MetronTrack, which basically allows you to compare different scan sets. The purpose for this is a way to compare different scans for a patient, whether it's for orthodontics or a wear case, for example, a patient wearing down their teeth every year, every time you see them in their examination. This feature allows you to monitor patients' oral changes and has some cool measurements and comparison tools. It sounds basic, but you really don't find a lot of these features in other scanners. Thirdly, they have a model builder called AccuDesign. This is a one-click model builder to allow scans to be converted into models for 3D printing. This software feature is becoming more and more widespread in the intraoral scanner market, and this is thanks to the rise of 3D printing. And I believe this will be a market norm with every scanner. And in this case, it works well enough. So model builders aside, then we have all the new CAD tools in the software. Yes, most scanners are now blurring what a scanner software does and what a CAD software does. And remember, this is still a completely free to use software. So there is CreSplint, a one-click splint or retainer CAD designer, which works okay, and although there could be improvements in the design, it is nice to see that this is being developed in the software. There's also CreTemp. This is a temp crown design software. So using AI, after you scan your prep, you can design temp crowns for a single tooth, which can be 3D printed. And lastly, we have CreIBT. This is a workflow to design indirect bonding trays. Yep, you guessed it, these can be 3D printed. This is more for the ortho crowd to allow for faster attachments of brackets for those out there that like to use indirect bonding trays. And that's really a wrap up of all the new software features. And I have to say, it's really quite amazing how much these companies are developing their software with these intraoral scanner these days. And they offer it all for free. This is no doubt something that Medit made very popular. But it's nice to see other companies competing in this way and offering full software suites. So, with the Aoral Scan 3 Wireless, the scanning is much the same as the previous generation Aoral Scan 3. It works well for a range of different indications and gives these hyper-realistic, almost photo-like scans, which when I post on social media, a lot of dentists really seem to like. The main focus so far seems to be software for the company, and they have done a lot in the past year. All of this is packaged with a cloud platform where you can store all your cases and also send cases. And this cloud platform is still completely free. Overall, I think it's a very competitive wireless scanner on the market at quite an economic price. Shining is really a company that is doing a lot in the digital space. And for those of you out there who may be looking for an entry-level wireless scanner, this is no doubt a scanner you should try. So that's everything for this video, guys. I've written a full review on this scanner, which you can check out at instituteofdigitaldentistry.com. I would love to hear your thoughts, however, and if you use the Aoral Scan 3 Wireless, how have you found it? Until the next video, guys, thanks for watching.